Hello everybody. Computer architecture. Now I would like to talk to you about number systems. Number systems is the system that we use for counting, for doing calculations. And the first thing that people normally observe is that our decimal system that everybody's using is actually based on the fact that we have 10 fingers, and therefore it would be nice to do the calculation with our fingers. But to show you that this argument is not correct, let me show you what the English people normally are using. They use the system based on 6. And this is caused by their hands. Because if you use your hands have 5 fingers, therefore it's easy to use the system based on 6. To show you how this works, look, I have here 2 hands, and this one will count the multiples of 6, and this will count the units. So let me do the counting. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, which is 2 times the base, plus 0, 13, 14, and so on. So you get the idea. Because we have 5 fingers on each hand, it is therefore easy to use the system that is based on 6. So this is how it goes. So we can actually use any system that we want. 10 is nothing special. It's not even that it's a round number, because 10 is a round number in any base system. For instance, the number 6 in the 6 base system is written as 1 0, 1 times the base plus 0 times the units. So this is then nothing special about 10. 6 would already be better, but the problem with 6 is that you get then already with small numbers you get a lot of digits. So there should be some kind of balance between the number of digits and the usefulness. So the other thing that was used in the world is the system based on 20. For instance, as I show here, the Mayans use this system based on 20. And they actually are one of the first, or maybe the first, that used a value symbol for 0. Others, they didn't even know the concept of 0. And this system actually is quite widespread. It's the Mayans on one side of the Atlantic, but also in Europe, it's also used. For instance, the French, they use it when they talk about 80, they talk about 4 times 20. That is then, of course, based on 20. 20 is also called a score. And this is quite often used as a base for a system of counting. Another one which is quite famous is the Babylonians, which actually we still use today, because this is gives the ground for our counting with minutes and seconds, because it's a system based on 60, or tens and sixes. As you can see here, it counted from 1 all the way up to 60. And in this case, that the advantage is that you have a small number of digits, even for big numbers, and on top of that, everything is divisible. And this divisibility, we will see later, that this is very useful when we go using floating point numbers. The things behind the floating point become very easy to calculate, because 60 is divisible by 2, by 3, by 4, by 5, and so on. It's divisible by many numbers, and therefore your calculation is very easy. And to show you somebody that a tribe that has completely messed it up, is the Romans. They used actually a system that is some kind of funny calculation of adding and subtracting, and then the position of the digit then depends on if you have to add it or subtract it. Well, I think it's so confusing that I am amazed that they could actually build such large structures like the Colosseum and so on, because that must be quite heavy calculations involved. But probably you know the system. For instance, 2018 would be written as MMXV. And this mm represents thousands, so you have to do some kind of calculation. Mm, 1000 plus 1000 plus 10 plus 5 plus 3. And if the I is standing before a larger value number digit, then it is subtracted. So this I here is subtracted from the 10. Well, that's quite confusing, isn't it? So what we actually what we are going to do, actually, which is very often used, is this system that you have here, that you have a series of digits, And the one on the right, so that is actually for you, that would be with my hands. This one is for you, is on the right, and this one is on the left. The ones to the left have a higher weight than the one on the right. So how does it go? Let me show you this here in this example. Imagine you have the number A, B, C, D, E, so you have five digits in a base of X. Then this one on the right, the least significant digit, is multiplied by one. And the one next to it is multiplied by the base. And the one next to that is multiplied by the base squared. And the one next to that is multiplied by the base cube, and so on. We can actually add here, we can in front of it, we can add as many digits as we want. To give you an example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in base 6 is simply 5, or 5 times 6 to the power 0, which is 5, plus 4 times 6 to the power 1, plus 3 times 6 to the power 2, plus 2 times 6 to the power 3, plus 1 times 6 to the power 4. And if you do this in the decimal system calculation, as you all know, this would be 1865 in the decimal system. So this is how we can learn from that. This is basically a system of representing numbers. And as we have seen before, the numbers, once again, the numbers don't exist in the computer. Everything is conventional, but this is the convention that we're going to use. And for binary numbers, for decimal numbers, this is constantly how we're going to do this. We will have a set of digits, and the one on the right will have the lowest weight, and the one on the left will have the highest weight. And every step is then a multiplication by the base. And there's one advantage for using the binary system, very simple, is that all modern computers, they use binary digital electronics, and therefore it is logical to do the calculations in binary, or use the binary number system. That is not to say that you cannot build a computer out of other things than binary electronics. For instance, the Russian, they had the ternary electronics, but at the end, the binary electronics, they have won, probably because it is the easiest to implement, for the simple reason that it just has two values of the voltages and currents and so on. And the binary numbers, well, there's a small joke here. I don't think it works if I read it out aloud, because then the joke is entirely lost, but I guess you get the joke. And to finish with this lecture, this short lecture on number systems, I would like to read you here some poetry. It's a limerick. As we already know, a dozen is 12, a gross is 144, and a score, which I talked to you about today, is 20. So you get this calculation in the form of a limerick that goes like this. A dozen, a gross, and a score, plus 3 times the square root of 4, divided by 7, plus 5 times 11, equals 9 squared plus 0, no more. Thank you for your attention.